Greetings. This is another video in a series answering a particular claim made by a Mohammedan. How can Islam be from Satan? We're discussing the hypothesis that Islam is from Satan. To make my point, I started this video thinking I would ask a series of guiding questions. The first question: if Satan were to create a religion, would Satan say, A, my religion will lead you to hell, or B, my religion is the only true religion? Let's take a look if we were to choose A, my religion will lead you to hell. Well, if you honestly think Satan will tell the truth, then you are not clear that Satan is evil and is the father of lies. And if you think Satan would say this exact phrase as his dua and invitation to follow him, you really think he is too stupid to even fool one soul into hell. So A is not a serious answer to the question. That leaves B for our consideration. My religion is the only true religion. Therefore, B is the correct answer. Question 1. If Satan were to create a religion, Satan would say, my religion is the only true religion. And what does Islam say? Islam is the only true religion. And that seems, at first, like a logical argument, right? Firmly establishing the case against Islam, proving it is from Satan. And it was about this point in preparing this video that I was reminded of a core reality of sharing the truth with Mohammedans. Christians must always be as logically honest as possible, or else they are guilty of the same fraud that Islam constantly commits. Because we worship God who is the truth. Not empty words, as Islam pays lip service to Al-Haq. So to be absolutely accurate, Christianity also says Jesus is the only way to salvation. We say this because Jesus said that he was the only way to salvation. But let's take a moment and look at the first question a little more. The question is straightforward in appearance, and the answers seem simple to understand. My religion will lead you to hell, or my religion is the only true religion. But this is an example of a false choice. The two answers or positions seem to be exact opposites of each other. And while their sentiments are exactly opposite, these two answers do not comprise all the things that Satan could possibly say. So this is a false choice because it is incomplete. But let me explain a false choice another way to make it more clear. A false choice is when you are given two options, as if they were the only two options, and you are forced to pick one of the two. In the most egregious examples, the two cases are intentionally chosen so that one is offensive, forcing you, therefore, to the control choice. So could my question be reformulated into a logically complete question? Yes, it could. If Satan were to create a religion, would Satan say, my religion will lead you to hell, or my religion will not lead you to hell? Those two statements are logically complete because they cover all the cases of that one phrase. They will lead you to hell, or they will not lead you to hell. Those cover the two complementary cases of that logic. In my example, the false choice is that Satan could only make one of the two provided claims. And simply by showing how stupid the straw man claim is, my religion will send you to hell, it pressures or attempts to force you to the other position. My religion is the only true religion. I see Didat and Nike often use similar logical fallacies as manipulative techniques.
I'm coming, Jesus Christ, if you have a chance of asking him, said, all right, oh Jesus, what is your religion? I do not expect him to say Christianity, because he also never heard the term. What do you expect him to say? We expect him to say that my religion is a religion of total submission to God's will. And one word for that in the Arabic language is Islam.
Would Jesus say, I am a Christian? Or would Jesus say, I submit to God? Of course, the word Christian simply did not exist before Jesus Christ was crucified, and even later than that. So you are naturally manipulated to reject that option of the false choice. And if you are unaware that all from Islam is deception, you may accept the second option. You accept the suggestion Jesus would say, I submit to God, and use exactly those words. And at that instant, Didat owns your thinking. If you accept Jesus said the words, I submit to God, you will buy it when Didat says, that is saying I am Muslim. Because saying I submit to God is saying I am Muslim. But this deceptive trick and trap is all predicated on a Mohammedan tricking you into accepting that Jesus would use these exact words. I submit to God. So Christians, whenever someone tries to force you into a decision with only two choices, whether a Mohammedan, an atheist, or even a Christian author, realize that a false choice is a manipulative technique, and God does not need such deception. The matter for you to discern, then, is whether the person intends to be deceptive or is simply incapable of creating a well-formulated logical construct. There is an adage that states, never ascribe to malice that which can adequately be explained by incompetence. Or, restated into modern English, never ascribe evil intent where simple stupidity is sufficient. Unfortunately, where Satan is involved, evil intent must be assumed, not dismissed or ignored. But realize it is Satan's evil intent, and not necessarily the speaker, who is simply a willingly ignorant minion of the devil. Use discernment and love the truth. And beware of false choices and bad Islamic logic. So, how exactly does this video address the thesis statement, how can Islam be from Satan? Any religion from God must seek and exhibit God's character. God's character is absolute truth. I find bad logic, errors, and outright lies in every video that I watch by Ahmed Didat and Zakir Naik. I find no evidence that anyone in Islam places any value in the truth. And that is evidence, but not necessarily a complete proof, that Islam has no regard for truth, facts, or logic. Islam shows over and over that it produces men who do not have an uncompromising commitment to the truth. The only thing Mohammedans have regard for is Mohammed's Quran. Therefore, it, Islam, cannot be from Almighty God. And if it is not from God, it is either from man or from Satan. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.